Tonight, Mark joins the metal god, Rob Halford, at the premiere for Fight War of Words.
Halford!
And John walks among Glenn Danzig's collection of books, shrunken heads, and other oddities.
I save a lot of stuff.
Plus, metal news, metal fans, and a metal jam within this moment. It's all coming up right now on Talking Metal on Fuse. In the garbage. It's John and Mark.
We've got an amazing episode of Talking Metal on Fuse tonight. John, how are you?
Doing great, and as usual, to my right, we have the one and only Bud Friendly.
And of course, Metal Mike has joined us yet again.
Metal for life. We've got the Talking Metal family here in the couch.
Sure.
Let's hear it. On the left, all the way from London, England, by way of Jersey City, we've got Paul Clemis, who
Yes, sir!
Now, Paul, I hear you terrorize your clients down at the stock exchange.
Yep, I'm the only metalhead down there, and God love them, they've been suffering for 6 years with my madness.
And we've got Ivy Supersonic, hat designer to the stars.
Yes.
Sonic,
very good.
Badass bitch.
She's a badass bitch. Now, Ivy, who have you designed hats for?
Pamela Anderson, Tommy Lee, Hillary Clinton, Monica Lewinsky.
And joining us with some shrimp cocktail, the leaders of the new wave of pirate heavy metal, Swashbuckle. Swashbuckle, crewed by the Dam. You're working on another one right now for Bald Freak Music. Looking forward to hearing that.
So Mark and I decided to switch things up a bit this episode and go off and do our own interviews.
We needed a little time apart.
So I headed out to L.A. and was invited into the home of Glenn Danzig.
Famous for Samhain, the Misfits, Danzig, of course, and we know there's so many fans of his music, from Johnny Cash to Metallica, have all done Danzig songs. And one thing you might not know, though, Bud Friendly, big fan of Danzig.
That's correct, Mark. Longtime fiend, part-time Martian.
Now, John, it's totally awesome that you got to actually go to Glenn Danzig's house. I mean, what is it like? Black clouds hanging over top of it, and the
afraid.
Elephant man
Let
bones
me tell you,
are in there.
I was a little afraid. I didn't see the elephant man's bones, but I did see a lot of other weird stuff. Now, I love these goat heads. This is out of control.
All right, yeah, so that's like a real goat head. This is a prop from the movie, the Hammer movie, The Devil's Bride. They have a bunch more goat heads, and like, there's a shrunken head right there.
I heard that you have a skeleton of a two-headed baby. Is that true?
Yeah.
That's insane. And can I check out your book collection?
Yeah, you want to go in the library, right?
Absolutely. Okay.
And I built this library just because I thought it would house all my books, and I was
wrong.
You have
too many books.
I have boxes of books that I still can't put up, so I have to build another library. Lucifer, the devil, Satan, black arts, magic, vampires, werewolves, voodoo. I ran out of space for all my voodoo books.
He had some pretty wild stuff in his house.
Right.
But my favorite was the Samhain and Misfits Ouija boards.
Yeah, these are prototypes for Ouija boards. There's a Misfits one, a Danzig one, and a Samhain one. So there's a Danzig one. You can see it's more traditional, kind of like.
Wow, it's great.
Ivy, any Ouija board experiences?
Oh my
that
God!
You...
Yeah, well, I'm a little bit witchy. Like I have a lot of like, I call them synchrosonic. Like you know, a lot of synchronicities, like every few hours.
Glenn has his own comic book company called Verotic. He's
cool.
Working with this guy named Biz, Simon Bisley, and they're going to work on a book as well.
We're working on a book right now that I'm putting out. It's going to be all the lyrics for Misfits, Danzig, or Samhain songs that never got published in the lyric sheets. So it'll be an illustration by Biz for the song, and then it'll be the lyrics.
Wow.
There's Wolf's Blood is in there, Die, Die, My Darling, Lords of the Left Hand, which is a Samhain song, tons of different stuff.
Renaissance man.
Absolutely. My favorite part of the interview is when I got to talk to Glenn about his current album, The Lost Tracks of Danzig. Now, what's really great about this record is it's a collection of a ton of cool tracks that, just for some reason or another, didn't make it on to all of Danzig's albums. What I like is that there are two discs, each with 13 songs, specifically. Yeah.
There's stuff that was supposed to be on EPs in between Danzig 6 and 7, and that's still in chronological order. And then I did the liner notes kind of for each song. Give a brief history for each track so you know kind of what record it was from or what session it was from and why it didn't make it and things like that.
And what's great about this is it spans his entire career. And there's stuff on here from the Sam Hain days, there's stuff from all of the different eras of Danzig.
Did he happen to mention he's gonna do another record soon?
And it looks like he definitely is.
I've written about 4 or 5 songs so far. If everything goes good, maybe it'll come out like late summer.
I just had such a great time hanging with Glenn. I really do think that me and him hit it off. We kind of look alike and you know, both have the black hair and we're kind of into the same kind of stuff. So
Virtual twins.
And I'm absolutely looking forward to hearing the new Danzig album.
Coming up, it's a war of words with Rob Halford.
It's okay.
More rowdy metal fans.
Yeah!
And a metal jam within this moment. Don't go away. Talking Metal on Fuse will be right back. But first, it's the Talking Metal Top 3 with Tommy Victor.
Hey, this is Tommy Victor from Prong and Ministry. I'm going to give you my top 3 reasons why LA is better than New York. One being, you only have to care about yourself. You can be narcissistic. Two, you can have a car. And three, you don't have to take the subway.
Monday on the Sauce, we've got a banging show. Kaylee Cuoco and Johnny Galecki are here from The Big Bang Theory.
And we'll tell you if baby mama rocked or slept through the weekend box office.
It's all coming up Monday here on the Sauce, 6 p.m. Eastern, live on Fuse.
Baby mama.
We're no FX. Screwing up since 1983. At these days we've got mortgages and families. So we're going on a sketchy tour. No country is too obscure. We're gonna drink and drop and fight and snort. We're no FX. This is Backstage Passport.
New episode of No FX Backstage Passport Tuesday at 10:30 on Fuse.
Brought to you by Warner Brothers' new motion picture, Speed Racer, in theaters May 9th.
Dream big.
All drivers to your cars.
Drive fast. And never look back. From the creators of the Matrix trilogy, let your imagination race.
Speed Racer is unstoppable.
Speed Racer.
See you at the finish line.
Rated PG in theaters and IMAX May 9th.
Welcome, former Space Shuttle Commander Rick Searfoss.
Oh, thanks. It's great to be here.
You've orbited the Earth over 600 times, and the people love that.
Yeah, I loved it too. But you guys hold the Guinness World Record for the best gas mileage around the world in a single trip. I'm curious, how did you do that?
Well, we do have more engineers than NASA.
No way.
Yes, way.
No, I don't believe that.
I can prove it.
No way.
You're pooping a little space pants.
No.
I'm telling you the truth.
Yee-haw! Howdy, it's me, Cowboy Jet. Come on down to the Mario Kart Emporium. People ask, Jet, how easy is it to drive in the new Mario Kart Wii game? And Jet says, get behind the wheel. Want to do a flip? Get behind the wheel. Want to pop a wheelie? Get behind the wheel. Want a power slide? Get behind the wheel. Still not convinced? Just look at Jet Jr.
This is great, Daddy.
Look at that boy. Every Mario Kart Wii comes with a Wii wheel. Rated E for everyone.
Some new shoes on and suddenly everything is right. I said, hey, I put some new shoes on and everybody's smiling. It's so inviting. Though short on money but long on time. Slowly strolling in the sweet sunshine. And I'm running late and I don't need an excuse. So I'm wearing my brand new shoes.
Secret encounters.
It's too late to go out, but I'm not tired enough for sleep.
perfect time to call Secret Encounters.
Secret Encounters is the best place to find buddies. You know, friends with benefits.
They have the most girls.
That's what Secret Encounters is all about. Connecting you with girls that are, you know, adventurous.
You should call Secret Encounters. Like right now?
Call 1-800-616-SEXY. Shh. Secret Encounters.
Ooh, this smells good.
That feels good.
Surprise your someone special with something sensual from AdamEve.com, like heavenly massage oil, tantalizing lingerie, or maybe something more adventurous. Right now, you'll save 50% on any item of your choice when you enter the offer code SEDUCE at checkout. So go to AdamEve.com,
you sexy devil, you,
and get ready for a night to remember.
Blood Truck, the new album from Finnish metal giants Children of Bodom. Catch them on Gigantor in April 12th. Children of Bodom, Blood Truck, in stores April 15th.
With more Talking Metal on Fuse. Over to you, John and Mark.
Nice. We got the Talking Metal family on the couch. Ivy, Supersonic, hat designer to the stars. Can you help Swashbuckle with their hats? I don't know about
that. Dude,
No, there's no hope there.
These hats, I'm speechless.
Okay.
Yes. I would just say, check out IvySupersonic.com.
IvySupersonic.com.
The they're nothing like this.
Okay.
The health department has just condemned the couch.
I had the honor of hanging out with one of the founding fathers of metal. It wouldn't exist without him.
Really, any bigger than this guy.
That, of course, is Rob Halford.
Now, we had the honor of interviewing Rob in a diner in New York City.
And he remembered that.
Which is amazing. I can't believe it.
This guy is so big, he probably does hundreds and hundreds of interviews. And he remembered hanging out with us in the diner for our podcast interview, which was available on TalkingMetal.com and iTunes.
What did Halford order at the diner?
You know, grilled cheese.
What sort of fuel fuels the metal god?
Absolutely. Grilled cheese and a Diet Coke. And I also can't believe that he watched the Talking Metal on Fuse pilot.
I think the show is terrific. There's nothing like it anywhere else. I'm sure it's going to be a huge success.
Well, thank you. I don't know if you saw, but in the show, we actually play one of our favorite Judas Priest songs.
That blew me away. Both you guys are great players. I had no idea. I mean, you told me about that before, but to actually see it happening. Are you going to do that with everybody?
We want to. You should come down and sing with
us. I'll do it. I'll do it. Definitely next time I'm in New York.
Rob has so much great music, from Judas Priest to Fight to Halford. Don't forget about Two. You know, it was really cool because I got to ask him what albums stand out when he looks back on his enormous catalog.
I think Sad Wings of Destiny will always be one of my favorite Priest releases. And so would also be British Steel. That was just a magical record, and that's become something of a classic now in time, you know. And it was the one that really kind of just took the band everywhere, that, with songs like Living After Midnight. That just became the defining moment on an international level, which again, you just don't expect, you
right.
know.
You know, and it was wild because Rob had so many great stories, and we got to talking about another very famous band from the UK, Led Zeppelin.
The last Led Zeppelin show ever in the United States.
Yes.
You guys opened that show, right?
I believe it was our Priest's first ever major US tour, and we were about to leave, and then we got a call from Robert saying, don't leave yet if you can, hang out for another week or so, because we're coming over.
Oh,
and
wow.
We'd like you to open up for Zeppelin. To get that request was a big surprise, and we said, we'll definitely stick around for that.
The amazing thing about Rob is not only does he love all the great hard rock and metal from the 70s and 80s, he's also very up on new bands and new music, and Judas Priest is doing new music right now, Nostradamus.
It's everything you love about Priest in terms of the tempo and the variety and the intensity and some very, very new, unusual types of performances as well.
I want to ask Commodore Redrum, in between his shrimps there, what he is expecting from the new Judas Priest record.
I'm expecting
it to be good.
Mike, you know any inside scoop on that?
Yeah, but I can't tell you.
What about Halford? Can we expect anything more from Halford, hopefully, in the future? Halford the band.
Of course. We've been working on a new studio record, tentatively called Halford 4, as you guys might know. When the time is right, that's when it's going to come out, and we're going to tour behind it.
Awesome.
But we're all looking forward to the new Priest. Me too, as a fan, I can't wait to hear it.
So many good stories coming from the Metal God. We sat down, had a great interview, then we headed over to a screening of his movie, Fight War of Words.
How cool is that?
It was cool, but we almost didn't make it.
The back of the door is open. We've just lost two crew members, a camera, and somebody's bottled water. That would have been tragic, wouldn't it? Me and Mark bouncing along Times Square.
We got over to the theater. It was packed with Rob Halford fans, all rocking out to the Fight movie, which was, believe me, very loud. I sat in the theater to watch it. And then he did a question and answer with his fans, which was really great.
Any chance of touring with Maiden again?
You know, I've always had this dream, you know, of like the ultimate metal experience at a stadium, like with Sabbath, Priest, and Maiden together.
The fans were great. It threw a lot of great questions at him, and some questions that took some guts or possibly a lot of alcohol to get up the nerve to ask Rob Halford.
What was the question? I would like to know.
What were you thinking without Turbo?
Well, you know, that's okay.
You gotta be kidding, Turbo Lovers.
I like the Turbo record.
Yeah, I'm a
like
fan of the Turbo record. Locked in.
Locked up.
Turbo. Locked up. I was just amazed how friendly and nice and down-to-earth this man is.
Yeah, he was great when we met him, and I'm jealous that you got a chance to go out and hang with the Metal God.
I speak for everybody here. You are the Metal God.
Yeah! Yeah! Thank you, bro.
Make sure you pick up the Fight War of Words film on DVD.
Stay tuned to discover and rediscover some metal gems. Plus, catch a killer metal jam within this moment when Talking Metal on Fuse returns. But first, a word from the metal fans. It's I Got Something to Say.
Metal's a way of life.
I think there's only like a few good groups out there that have been, you know, remaining constant. One's Iron Maiden. Another's Anthrax.
Well, real bands, Megadeth, Dream Theater, Kiss Ass, number one, they're the best. The old stuff, Iron Maiden, okay? You got Sabbath still playing together, even though they're like 500 years old, but they're still playing together. You gotta enjoy these people.
Big Show, Big China, Big Trouble.
Counterfeit tickets should be pretty easy to catch at the door, no?
Not the way the Chinese do it.
I love China.
New episode of NoFX Backstage Passport, Tuesday at 10:30 on Fuse.
In our darkest hour, our friends and family stood up and stood by us. For more than a decade, they were the ones who supported us and sacrificed to keep us inspired.
The Brooklyn Way. New episode tomorrow at 10:30 Eastern, 7:30 Pacific.
A new force of evil is arising. Every pirate must band together to fight his dark magic.
Oh, not good.
Live the life of a notorious pirate as you join Jack Sparrow and thousands of players in Pirates of the Caribbean Online. Captain your ship, battle fierce enemies, live the legend. Play for free at piratesonline.com. Rated 10 for ages 10 and up.
You're next.
There's been speculation that I was
a superhero.
I'm just not the hero type. Clearly.
Two vodka martinis. Looking dirty. Iron Man, that's kind of catchy.
Rated PG-13.
Rated T-14. Rock Band, drum set, and wireless guitar now sold separately.
New
the cheesy bacon BK wrapper.
He's so good with his hands.
The breakfast of tomorrow, today.
Now there's something you can do to protect the future of your skin. New Clean and Clear Soft, an oil-free moisturizer with white tea antioxidant and the SPF you need to protect your skin from environmental stress like sun and pollution. We got something, it feels good. No, get your best skin. Soft, healthy, protected. And to complete your skincare regimen, try the entire line of Clean and Clear Soft. Clean and clear and under control.
The new Butterfinger Comedy Network, only on Yahoo. Good times, man. Good times. Go to Yahoo and search Butterfinger.
Worlds Collide, the new album from Apocalyptica. With I'm Not Jesus, featuring Corey Taylor. Special guests include Adam Gontier from 3 Days Grace and Christina Scabbia from Lacuna Coil. Worlds Collide, in stores now.
I thought you were a good man. I thought you talked.
In his advice column, Dan is an expert on everything.
Very good column, sir.
What else can I do for you?
I'd like to see your daughter.
Come back in 2 years.
Dad!
But as a single father...
Go now. Okay, stop.
He doesn't have a clue.
Sorry, student driver!
I miss your eyes.
When it comes to the unexpected...
Dad!
Nothing beats real life. Steve Carell.
This is gonna cost you.
Put it on my tab.
What was that?
Put it on my tab.
Dad in real life. Rated PG-13.
Secret Encounters.
They want me to tell you why you should call Secret Encounters. Well, let me tell you why I call. There's lots of lines for older people looking to get married, but what if you just want to have fun? That's Secret Encounters. So if you're just looking for easy fun, like a friend with benefits, on the phone or in person, you should call Secret Encounters. Like right now?
Call 1-800-7000-HOT. Secret Encounters.
Hello, all you Rugrats. My name is Mike Patton, and you are watching Talking Metal on Fuse.
Welcome back to Talking Metal on Fuse. This just in, it's time for heavy news.
Sepultura back in the studio. Here's an exclusive clip straight out of Brazil.
Cool, I want to see this.
Yeah, whatever, man.
So what's going on right now?
We're here in São Paulo, working on the new album. Just working some riffs, some ideas. And we have a lot of stuff already. And we are working on, inspired by the book from Anthony Burgess, The Clockwork Orange. And, you know, early stages still, but so far so good.
Sounds like it's gonna be a great record. Any Sepultura fans here?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
definitely.
Are you a fan of the newer stuff they've been putting out?
You know, I really am a fan of Derek Green. I think he's great. And I love all the Max Cavalera stuff as well. I'm really looking forward to Cavalera's Conspiracy. That's going to be dropping really soon on Roadrunner.
The two brothers back together.
So hopefully we're going to get to see both of those bands on tour this year or maybe next year.
It's time for the Lost Classic.
Fate's Warning Parallels, an amazing overlooked record. Progressive metal, you always hear about Queensrÿche, Dream Theater. What about Fate's Warning? Mike, big fan too, right?
One of my favorite records from Fate's Warning. Probably my most favorite record from Fate's Warning.
And that was the Lost Classic.
It's always cool to go from a Lost Classic to talking about the classic metal tunes we get to jam on.
We've had a lot of fun playing just great metal standards, if you will, with a lot of great musicians, and tonight is no exception. In This Moment, one of my favorite new bands.
Absolutely, one of my favorite bands.
We jammed on I'm Broken by Pantera, one of the best metal songs. I'm broken. any Pantera fans on the couch.
Yar.
Oh, sh**.
Yeah,
calm down.
Yar. Yar.
The whole couch.
Turn it up to 11 and get ready for a metal jam.
Maria, let's talk about the actual vocal part of the song.
He has such dimensions, and he's so strong. And then I was listening to it, and they overcross. And I'm like, how does he pull this off live? So I went and looked, and I'm like, oh, okay, Dimebag's doing it. So we were thinking, who can do it? And we absolutely adore Jose from Sirius. And so we called him. He came in, ripped it up, puked, and it was awesome.
The biggest Pantera fan ever. I was into Pantera before Cowboys came out. And I'm broken. It's just like, how do they keep coming up with these phenomenal, heavy, amazing riffs?
What do you think of Vinnie Paul?
Oh, it's a real pain in the ass to learn his drum decks. Period.
We had so much fun jamming within this moment.
We have those like hardcore people we think about who have been supportive, and like you guys have been. We appreciate that.
Cool. Thank you.
It's cool to have Talking Metal and Jose together at the same time.
Yeah,
I think it's great. I want to thank the Talking Metal viewers. I want to thank Bud Friendly, Metal Mike, and the Talking Metal family on the couch.
This couch has been great.
Check out views.tv/talkingmetal for some extras that didn't make the show. And subscribe to the Talking Metal podcast at www.talkingmetal.com. We'll see you next time. All right.
My wife is 8.5 months pregnant with our third child. We're gonna get another one of these guys. The Brooklyn Way. New episode Thursday at 10:30 Eastern, 7:30 Pacific. Right here on Fuse.